Thank you. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the thank you.
Hello, my name is Hannah Mafuka and I am the president of DSA's History Club. Today we virtually gather to acknowledge the complexities of the lives and experiences of Black people. More specifically, today we focus on the Black family in terms of representation, identity, and diversity. This will by no means be a one-dimensional assembly. The Black family can be fun, loving, comedic, intense, passionate, struggling, ambitious, lethargic, nonchalant, joyful, amusing, hurting. In any given situation, there are uplifting aspects as well as challenging ones, and this element of intricacy is prominent in the assembly. Expect to see the depiction of the Black family in film and literature juxtaposed with respective realities. Expect provocative and sometimes uncomfortable language, but equally expect jubilant, gleeful dances and other forms of artwork. As Oprah Winfrey once said, we've got to keep telling our stories because our experiences are so broad and rich and multifaceted that there isn't just one way to be Black or ish. The more stories we share, the more reflective we can be of the whole diverse African-American community. Through engaging in this content, you will gain different perspectives on not only how the world was, but on how it is now, and arguably, most importantly, how it should be. Thank you.
And now, here is Isabella Brathwaite with Codfish and Bakes.
My grandma is from Jamaica and my grandpa is from Barbados. So my dad is what he calls a Beige American. One thing that is a big part of our culture and is something that we bond over is food. My grandma and my auntie have taught me how to make all our staple recipes. When I was around 10, they taught me how to make a dish we call codfish and bakes. Codfish and bakes is kind of like a fish stew served with a pan-fried biscuit. When my dad and auntie were kids, my grandma would make codfish and bakes for breakfast every Sunday. And that tradition still lives on. Whenever we're together on a Sunday, we always eat codfish and bakes as a family.
How did this tradition start? Did you eat codfish and bakes when you were a kid, or where did the tradition
start? Jamaica, it's called fish and fried dumplings. I started making it, I was about 10. My mother taught me how to do it.
What's your earliest memory of eating codfish and bakes?
My earliest memory, I really can't remember. We grew up just eating. It was every Sunday we had codfish and bakes. And it's interesting because it's called bakes because your grandpa was from Barbados. In Barbados, they call them bakes. And in Jamaica, it's called fried dumplings. So it was like a marriage between the marriage of grandma and grandpa, my mom and dad, of mom being from Jamaica and grandpa being from Barbados, and taking on calling it bakes. So it's like the Jamaican side and the Barbados side came together and called it codfish and bakes. But if you ask Jamaicans, they say fried dumplings. And okay. Bajans, or bar people from Barbados, call it bakes.
Remember you telling me sometime where it was like, how many bakes, at least when you were younger, do you think you could eat at once? Like, I know you and Uncle Jimmy would like eat a ton of them. So.
My grandma would make additional bakes for me and my brother, because we would eat so many more bakes because we would sop the gravy up with the bakes, and that would be our little thing. And we'd have a contest to see how many we would eat at any one time. I think the most I ate was 8. And my brother could just keep on going. I don't even know how many he could. He'd always win because he would eat them all the time. The fact that I have enjoyed that for all of my childhood and now with my daughter, it's been great.
And now we have Lily Sledge's piece, Juneteenth.
Show white woman fly, black of history's shame I rise. Up from a past rooted in pain I rise. A black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling and bearing in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear I rise. Into a daybreak miraculously clear I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the hope and the dream of the slave. And so, there I go.
And now we have four different pieces by the Deaf Poets Society.
What you see is not always what it's meant to be. In my black family, there's always something amiss to me. People always think we don't have fathers or that our mothers are single and struggling on their own. But really, our households can be quite complete and honed. Some of us work so hard trying to build the perfect familial image, but we get lost trying to imitate this imperfection from sinners. The homophobia and the hate that resides in the wood panels of my bedroom floor. The colorism that wraps on our front and kitchen doors. Don't be dark and definitely don't be gay. Don't stray from he or she and be a they, cause then it's trauma induced all over again. Everything can be tied back to slavery, my friend. But nowadays our hate is more self-inflicted. Our elders refuse to move on from a life that's gilded. They train us to hate ourselves because of what they were taught. Compete with their own kids, even in thoughts. Don't get me wrong, it's not all sour. A black family is a village that exudes power. Don't get it twisted, we will trip you up. Our bonds are stronger than iron and our loyalty is taught. So no, we don't always stay together. Maybe we do struggle to keep forever. But we'll always come back to where that good cornbread was made and embrace what we know to love, our families we crave.
I stand proud as a black woman in a black household, full of black young boys and a black mom, who raises us in a world where all the television displays is blonde hair, blue eye characters, where the plot centers around situations I can never relate to, where the only bit of representation I got on screen was the black girl with curly hair who plays the token character to stand on the side and forces herself to relate to those situations created by the blonde hair, blue eye characters. Where their only purpose is to be the best friend who agrees with everything but is heavily neglected and made fun of throughout. Where any movie with a whole black family is the same movie where they are in shackles the whole time, begging for mercy from the monstrous blonde hair, blue eye characters, as if our history started and stopped with slavery. We live in a world where it becomes controversial for the black girl with 4C hair and natural curves to blandly exist, while the blonde hair, blue eye characters could cause chaos and everyone laughs and lets it slide. During movie nights with my family, we watch sci-fi, and all I can think is that we have to go as far away from real and our reality as we possibly can because our reality is misrepresented. I say all this to say that we are in control of our story. My family, as gorgeous as can be, we walk in the house, yes, humming our rap music. We go to sleep, yes, with our bonnets and do-rags on. We wake up, yes, with this fine, precious skin that so many try to mock. We wear, yes, any clothes we want because our bodies are divine. My black family doesn't follow nobody's blueprint or nobody's stereotypes because we are the foundation. No matter how much they strip away who we are and try to rewrite our stories, they can never take away the strength that the black family has. Thank you.
I am more than the loud black woman. And I'm more than the sassy black girl. And I'm more than the comedic relief. Mm-hmm. And I'm more than the mammy character type. And I'm more than the one era of history you decide to share over and over and over again. I am so much more than that. We are so much more than that. We are so much more than that.
curling up in my mother's lap, stroking my hair, admiring her creation, a joy I can't explain. Singing in the kitchen, hips moving side to side, smiles grinning from ear to ear. If time could stop, I would spend my final days here. Sweaty hands clenched on the wheel, breaking hard at every stop sign. My father sighs as he grins. His laugh lines remind us I'm the last time he will give driving lessons. College bound, my bloodhound, now old, watching as I pack to leave. Last pieces of advice, my brother already paid the price. Why have me make the same mistakes when he knows what's right? I smile now, it's my turn to step into the world. Not alone, I have a village behind me. The world might try me, but I'm not doing it alone. Beads adoring my body reminds me this is not the first challenge I face. Excitement because I'm protected. These beads were blessed only for this face. I step into my own support behind me. My future is here because of my ancestors' fate. I honor them. I am them. I'm living history you can't erase.
All right, now we have Krucial presents Welcome to Atlanta.
Jacking hammers and bows, back to the mackin' and jacking the clothes. Adolescents packing a bow, a knock on the door.
Who is it?
I would happen to know the one with the flow.
Who did it?
It was me, I suppose. Jay-Z in the rolls and looters in the cut supreme. Skating down old Nat, tucked and lean. I split your spleen, as a matter of fact, I split your team. No blood on the sneaks, gotta keep it so my kicks is clean. I get the cream, cops see me flick my beams. I'm allergic to doc prescribed antihistamines. Oink, oink, pig, pig, do away with the pork. Only silverware needs a steak knife and a fork. Did you forget your manners? I'm Bruce with banners. Ludacris, Johnny Rockets when I shoot the cannon. The woolly mammoth saber tooth, bite your tongue. I won't stop until I'm rich as them whites will come. I pull up in a black Lotus, your plaques are bogus. So I strip them off the wall, waiting for my cue to corner pocket eight ball. You racking them up on big paper like pancakes, stacking them up. In fact, I'm slapping them up. Cadillac is a truck, I can't lose with 22s. That's what's up. Running in the back, the better than the aqueduct. Chilling in the wood.
Yo. Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Now the party don't start till I walk in and I usually don't leave until the thing is. But in the meantime, in between time, you work your thing, I work mine. I've been putting it down here since 83, since the Lake Show MD rivalry, when Frozen Paradise was the place to be. If you was riding, you was bumping the homie Shy D. I'm the MVP, most ballin'est player. Make my own rules, call me the mayor. Monday night, Gentlemen's Club. Tuesday night, I'm up in the Velvet Room, get up. Wednesday, I'm at Strokers on Lean. Thursday, jump clean, then I fall up in cream. Friday, Shark Bar Kaya with Frank Ski. Right on the flow is where you can find me. Saturday, is off the Heezy for Sheezy. You can find me up in one Tweezy. Sunday, is when I get my sleep in. Cause on Monday, we be at it again. Holla, to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
This will be DRC dancers performing I Am Not My Hair.
Is that India? What happened to her hair?
Little girl with the pressing curl. Age 8, I got a Jerry curl. 13, and I got a relaxer. I was a source of so much laughter. And 15, when it all broke off. 18, and I went all natural. February 2002, I went on and did what I had to do. Because it was time to change my life. To become the woman that I am inside. 97 dreadlocks all gone. I looked in the mirror for the first time and saw that hey, I am not my hair. I am not this skin. I am not your expectations. No, no. I am not my hair. I am not this skin. I am the soul that lives within.
What'd she do to her hair?
I don't know. It looked crazy.
I like it.
I wouldn't go that far.
Does the way I wear my hair make me a better person? Does the way I wear my hair make me a better friend? Oh, does the way I wear my hair determine my integrity? I am expressing my creativity. No, I am not my hair. I am not this skin. I am the soul that lives within. I am not my hair. I am the soul that lives within. So if I want to shave it close, so I want to rock the locks, that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got. If I want to wear it braided all down my back, I don't see nothing wrong with that.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for bearing with us with all of our technical difficulties today, and thank you for even coming to our assembly. I was supposed to introduce our guest speaker for today, but unfortunately, we cannot get him to join the teams, so we will be having our guest speaker on another day. Just unfortunately, that day cannot be today.
Well, thank you, folks. As we continue to move forward in virtual learning, we are learning how to roll with the punches and just try to adjust. But I want to say thank you so much to our History Club, as well as Mr. Landis, and thanks to our guest speaker who unfortunately couldn't join at this time. But thank you so much for putting this assembly together, and we definitely look forward to more sharing from you, our student body, for Black History Month. The Black family as a unit and as a collective, it represents a lovely cornucopia of traditions and contributions that spread throughout our diaspora. I'm thankful for my own family unit and my collective Black family, consisting of immigrants and people who were born and bred right here in America, reared across the country in small and big cities and East and West Coast, and even here in the Jim Crow South years back. Although these experiences differ from generation to generation, friend to friend, aunt to uncle, cousin to cousin, one thing remains the same. Is that all our experiences as melanated people have shaped who we are and who we will be As we move into Black History Month, let us continue awakening, controlling our story, and owning the beauty of our cultures. The contribution of melanated peoples will continue to be seen as we seize opportunities to uncover more about who we are and share contributions with who we will be. Our history extends beyond 1619 and L'Amistad and Clotilda. Remember, you are descendants of Mansa Musa and Nefertiti, the Kush and the great Zimbabweans, kings and queens, pharaohs, inventors, educators, and great thinkers. Family, we are awakening, and the ancestors are depending on you, the next generation, to continue to tell the story and add to it. Our lovely and talented young people here at DSA will be an integral part of the future as Americans and as Black Americans. And we're so thankful and so grateful for you and all the contributions that you have given and will soon give. Thank you so much, and let's have a lovely Black History Month. Thank you.